So now we are practicing, we are about to practice a question which is related to ACCA taxation section C type question. So this is a specimen exam question, but this question is based on the information that is related to year end 31st March 2017, but we will apply the rules of tax year 19 and 20 in considering the solution. So you can see that this is a question. The following scenario relates to two requirements. So in this question, we have two requirements. The first requirement in front of you, prepare a revised version of corporate tax computation for the year ended 31st March 2017. So what you have to do, you have to calculate or prepare the corporate tax computation revised. And your calculation should commence with the profit before tax figure of 274,530. And you should indicate by the use of zero any item in the computation of trading profit for which no adjustment is needed. Now, as we know that we have to recalculate the corporate tax computation. So what we have to do, we'll prepare a pro forma, first of all, for the corporate tax computation. And you can see here that similar pro forma, you have to copy it right here. So it's like corporation tax computation. So this is the, you can put this heading, corporation tax computation for the year ended, say suppose 31st March 2017. Now, as per the pro forma, first of all, should know you have to show trading profit, tax adjusted trading profit, and then the loan interest. And if you add together these two value, then it becomes the total profit. And there is QCD. So left over then QCD. If this is QCD, then TTP. And then the tax rate. And then it's corporate tax liability. So this is the basic pro forma we can use. You can also increase or decrease the space here. So let me just first. So this is the, you can make it bold. So this is the information. Now we know that we don't have trading profit, the actual trading profit, because it's now being the wrong information. So what you have to do, so in working number one, we have to prepare a trading profit. So let's move to prepare a trading profit working. So the heading is trading profit. Now we have to start from profit before tax figure of 274,530. So it's 274,530. Now see the item, depreciation 1570. So what is the treatment of depreciation? It is to be added back. So for my ease, I'll make this depreciation. What is the treatment? Added back. It's a non-allowable expense. So depreciation is added back. The second item is donations to political parties. So donation is, what is the treatment of donations? Again, added back, not allowed. What is the qualifying charitable donation? QCD. What is the rule of QCD? QCD is not allowed here as an expense, rather it is a part of the main working. So what you have to do, you have to add it back here and you have to deduct it from there. So you have to deduct it from there. Their QCD. So less QCD. Now you can directly write here as well, and you can also relate the value of this there. So let me just relate the value. Put is equal to here minus sign, because you have to show the minus amount, and click on this cell, enter. So you can see that the value has been copied. as -900. Done. Now, accountancy charges. We have accountancy charges. We have legal fee in connection with issuance of loan stock, entertaining supplier, entertaining employees, gift to customer of food hampers, capital allowance, working number 3, trading profit, and so on. So, what about accountancy? Is accountancy an allowable expense? So we know that the accountancy is an allowable expense. So put accountancy charges 2300. So it's accountancy charges 2300 as it is allowed. So put 0. What about legal fee in connection with the issues of loan note for trading purpose? Legal fee. If it is loan note, then it is allowed. Comes in exception. Entertainment of supplier. What about the entertainment of supplier? Entertainment of supplier is not allowed. So it's supplier entertainment not allowed. So we have to write 3600. What about the other treatment? Entertainment of employee. Entertainment of employee is always allowed. 0. And gift to customer. If the customer gift is meeting the condition, that is cost less than £50 and carrying conspicuous advertisement, not a food item, then it is allowed. So gift is allowed. 0. What about the another gift? Gift to customer, food hamper. Food hamper is not allowed. So 1650, you have to add it back. Now, other than that, now we have capital allowances. So we have to work out capital allowances. We have to work out capital allowances. So another working, that is capital allowances, working within working, that is capital allowances. Now we know to prepare a pro forma of capital allowances. You can see here, there is main pool item, there is motor car, there is a special rate item. So we have to find out the mistake as well. Motor car is a separate item. So we know that in company, there will be no separate column. So ideally, let's make 3 columns. One is main pool. Other is special pool. And we have allowance. Now let's identify the figures. Make it bold. So let's identify the figures. We have written down value, brought forward main pool 12,400. So TWDV brought forward, it's 12,400. It's 13,600. And now we have addition. We have addition of a machinery. We have addition of a motor car. We have addition of motor car too. And they have calculated annual investment allowance on that. But we know that on motor car, there is no annual investment allowance. Motor car one has a CO2 emission of 110 gram per kilometer. Motor car has a emission of 155 gram per kilometer. And this car is used by sales manager and 50% of the mileage is for private journey. All of these included in a special rate pool at 1st April. All of the item in a special pool was sold during the year for 9,300. The original cost was 16,200. So what we have to do, first of all, we have to put addition. And in addition, we have machinery, and the machinery cost is 42,300. In the tax year 1920, we have AIE available of 1 million. So the whole value is available as, put here minus sign, and we have to show here is the positive sign. So in order to make it positive, put minus here and then click on this. So you'll get the 42,000 annual investment allowance calculated. Now the next thing is the machinery motor car one. So we have motor car one. The motor car one is part of the main pool item, and motor car two is, motor car one is part of main pool item. Main motor car one is 13,800. So it's 13,800. Motor car two is part of a special pool, and its worth is 14,000. Its worth is 14,000. Done. Now we have to show the disposal proceed. One, all the items in the special pool has been sold at the lower of 9,300 and 16,200. We always see the lower amount. So in this way we have, now what you have to do? We have to calculate the total, and then we have to calculate the written down allowance. So main pool opening balance 12,400, motor car one is 13,800. Now we have to apply the function of sum is equal to sum, bracket open, select this cell, drag it down to this, and you can see there is a total of 26,200. And the same special pool, so this is 18,300. Now apply WDA. WDA is 18%. So we have to apply here, it is an 18%. So is equal to, take this value, take multiply sign 0.18. So you'll get the figure of WDA of 4716. And here you can see WDA of 6% on special pool item. So it's is equal to, take the value, multiply 0.06, you get the figure of this. Now put in the allowance section. So, and here we have to show minus. So put minus here. Here we have to show minus as well. So put minus here. Now we have to relate this to allowance section, but we have to show the positive value. So in order to get it positive, click on this. It is positive. Here positive as well. So this make it positive. Now the total of TWDV carried forward. So in this way we have is equal to sum equal to. Now from this figure we have to deduct this. So this is the closing balance, and here you can see is equal to sum, and this is the balance, deduct this closing balance, and now the total of allowance, so is equal to sum, and from this figure plus all three items. Although it was written as that all of the special pool item has been disposed of, but we haven't calculated the balancing allowance or balancing something like that. We haven't calculated balancing allowance because there will be no balancing allowance on special pool item. Rather, a charge can be used. So in this way, the total allowance is this is the total allowance value. Now we have to show this total allowance to the second working here. We have to show here capital allowances. We have to show here. So that means is equal to minus and relate with this figure. So this is the type of figure. Enter this. So you can see minus 48114. So in this way, capital allowance working has been done. And the figure, finally, we have to calculate the tax adjusted trading profit. So it's tax adjusted profit figure, make the total. So total is equal to sum, bracket open. And you have to move around the figure, select this. And from this, select this figure and drop it down. So it will give you a answer of 248706. So this is the tax adjusted trading profit. Now this tax adjusted trading profit is to be transferred to the main working here, tax adjusted trading profit. So is equal to, and this is the positive figure. So this is the value we have transferred. Now we have to work out the loan interest figure, that is working number two here. So loan interest receipt, it was mentioned that the loan was made for non-trading purpose. It means it will be part of the main working. And you have to add in trading profit. Now the accrual method is to be allowed. So loan interest receivable, opening balance, closing balance, and loan interest received. So we have to check that if there is any mistake in that. If not, we will take the right figure. So opening balance is 10,600 and closing balance is 32,100 is taken as loan interest income, while 32,100 is cash received. So cash received is not to be considered. Rather, loan interest receivable is to be considered. So the value is 32,800. So you can directly put value here, 32,800. In this way, we have trading profit, tax adjusted, loan interest, correct value minus QCD. So we are in a position to calculate TTP. And this is the positive value. This is the positive. This is the negative value. And we have TTP of this. Tax rate is current tax year. This is 19%. So let's apply is equal to this figure multiplied by 0.19. You'll get a figure of this. So we'll adjust this. This is CT at the rate of 19%. So this is the value. Now, if you have to show the value without decimal, then click on this and show the custom value without any decimal. Apply. You can see 53315. This is the final corporate tax liability. So this is the requirement. Prepare a revised revision of NIV Limited corporate tax liability for the year ended 31st March 2017. Now if you move to the next requirement. So the next requirement is a theory. You can see that The managing director of Neev Limited understand that the company will have to file its self-assessment return online and that the supporting accounts and tax imputation will have to be filed using the inline extensible business reporting language. The managing director is concerned about how the company will be able to produce document in this format. Explain the option available to N Limited regarding the production of accounts and tax computation in the IXBL format. So you can just write three points here. One is the use the software provided by HMRC. Use other software that convert it in the same format and use tagging. So you can write it in paragraph. I just make the bullet point. We can use the, do not use the bullet rather than write the full paragraph. In this way you can use, you can get 3 marks, and this is the 15 marks question of section C of the ACCA TX exam.